prior to prophethood, let's take a look at some of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and what we should be asking ourselves. Firstly, as he became or he was adolescent, he was known as As-Sadiq al-Amin. I'm sure we all know that. I'm sure we're all aware of that. What does it mean? It means the truthful, the trustworthy. How many of us are truthful and trustworthy? How many of the youth out here are trustworthy and truthful? That was young age, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not yet given that nubuwwah, which he was given at the age of 40. Although he was always meant to be the Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, indeed. He was created the best of creation, the most noble of all prophets, without a doubt. But at the same time, how many of us would be able to follow that example and say, yes, I am also a truthful person, upright, and I am honest. I am trustworthy. Today, our spouses cannot trust us. People say, well, the trust is broken and it's lost. I can't trust my husband anymore. I can't trust my wife anymore. Where is As-Sadiq al-Amin? There is no use, no point in us keeping on saying, oh, mashallah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, peace be upon him, was As-Sadiq al-Amin. As-Sadiq al-Amin. You're telling the whole world. You're teaching that to the children. You're teaching that to everyone else. How did you benefit from it? Talk about that. When we speak of role models, what is of utmost importance is the fact that we realize that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Creator Himself, says that such and such a person is the ultimate role model, we stop there. We understand that this is the Creator of creation who is speaking. He is the one who is instructing us, who is telling us. And therefore, every one of us needs to ask ourselves a question. And that question is, how close or far are you from emulating exactly that which Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has brought? When Allah says in Surah Al-Ahzab, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو اللَّهِ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Indeed, in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best, the perfect example to be emulated. Al-Uswatul Hasana. Al-Hasan here referring to the best, referring to that which is perfect, the perfect example to be followed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For whom? For those who are looking forward to the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who want Allah, who want to meet Allah, who want to get closer to Allah. That is your example and that is what you need to follow. And the verse continues to say, whoever is looking forward to the last day, on that last day, you will meet those whom you love. In the hereafter, you will meet even with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How amazing is that? It's a gift for the believers. And Allah says, for those who remember Allah often, if you remember Allah often and you are always reminding yourself of Allah, the term dhikrullah, yes, it refers to your subhanallah, alhamdulillah, your praise of Allah. But over and above that, it also refers to, or more importantly, it refers to the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's the point of a person saying subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar? Their deeds are in a valley and the statement uttered from their mouths in another valley altogether, in two different directions. It's important for us to know that if you want to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes, indeed, that will help you. If you want to praise Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it will indeed help you. But on condition that you are following his method, his way, his example, and your life is not being led totally separately or heading in the other direction. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. So this is the example. Are you known as As-Sadiq al-Amin? Are you trustworthy? Are you a person who is truthful? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive every single one of us. Ameen.